Hey everyone, Joshua Kirk here with you once again, and now it's time for episode 286 of Album of the Day, in which for today's album review, I'm going to be looking at a Virginia guitarist who has been around for like, I've at least half a decade at this point, and this record of hers I'm going to be reviewing today, I believe, is her second full-length album, because I know she put out one other album in 2018, and she is an artist sort of doing that very progressive, kind of primitive, instrumental, acoustic folk music, using her acoustic guitar and some very interesting and unique playing techniques, such as playing the guitar on her lap, and also kind of using her guitar as a percussion, playing it in a percussive way, that's very interesting. I discovered her through NPR, which is why I'm wearing this t-shirt. So I'm talking about the guitarist known as Yasmin Williams, and I'm here to review her latest record, which came out on January 28th, or 29th, of 2021. And the album is called Urban Driftwood, and I discovered Yasmin Williams through listening to NPR's All Songs Considered and on Music Friday. I may have mentioned that segment a few times. It's a weekly segment where they talk about the newest albums, their favorite ones, released on a particular Friday of the week, and in this case it was January 29th, it may have been, and they were talking about this record and kind of the inspiration behind it, and I thought it sounded so fascinating, you know, for a instrumental folk record, a kind of style I don't normally gravitate towards that much, but when I listened to this album, man, was I not ready for just how beautiful and serene and how, like, awe-inspiring this instrumental guitar record really is. Even though it definitely takes a lot of its roots from, you know, classic primitive folk music, it also definitely takes inspiration from other kinds of music, like progressive rock, or progressive metal, or even like, you know, as Ian Cohen mentioned on Uproxx's IndieCast, like ambient metal. So it's definitely the kind of thing that would appeal to not just fans of folk music like me, but also fans of kind of progressive rock music, or there are even some metal heads that I think would totally mess with this shit, because it totally is quickly shaping up to be one of the best albums of the year. With most reviews, I would probably be very descriptive with how I describe certain songs, but considering this album is relatively simplistic and, you know, doesn't really have lyrics, this review is going to be relatively straightforward and efficient, because really there's just so many great tracks on here that sort of, you know, embody a certain kind of theme or aesthetic. Like, the album actually flows very well, and songs like the track I Wonder, for example, actually very much tell a story through these very beautiful and progressive guitar passages, and some of the best and most complex melodies I've heard all year. Like, that song is a really good example of that, and I think the opener, Sunshowers, is definitely a very gorgeous way to sort of set the tone for the record. Like, immediately when I turn that on, I'm not really thinking about much else except what I'm listening to, and any kind of stress I may have had from the day or something like that, I just turn on that do 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 do, And then it progresses into that dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee-dee. And I just like, yeah, any sort of, you know, kind of strain of, you know, negative emotion I may have, like, it just kind of melts away, like, when I turn this track on. And I think it's a very beautiful intro, and also the lead melody that plays throughout the song is just like, it very much, you know, gives me just sort of, you know, this very powerful serotonin blast that I sometimes need. I also really dig the track Juvenescence. I think that song is a pretty strong contender for my favorite track on the record. Like, the melody on the song is, like, so catchy, and I think this is one of the first tracks where the kind of more symphonic tendencies of Yasmin shine, and they do so incredibly well with the way she layers and multi-tracks her guitar. I mean, for a record that's composed out of mostly just her acoustic guitar, she really manages to feel like an orchestra. There's 10 guitar players in the studio literally just jamming and also just telling this story that has... I mean, this is one of those albums where, even though it's instrumental throughout, the different... So all the songs, like, you know, have kind of a proper, you know, opening, like a cold open, and then kind of a bit of a reoccurring conflict, and then there's a climax, and then by the end of it all, there's a resolution. I think that is very apparent from a track like the next one, Dragonfly, which is also a highlight for me. This song, I definitely think, also has some very strong and kind of hypnotic melodies on there. And I think you could apply this album's, like, indisputable beauty to its album cover as well. I mean, the album cover fits pretty well with the way this album sounds. It's like a reflection of a forest, like there's, you know, some sun and clouds. You could see the trees in there. It's like a reflection in a river, and that's exactly what this album feels like. It has this very domestic and kind of, you know, naturalistic feel to it that I definitely think is a cool little, you know, if you want a little escapism in your life, this record is definitely the way to go. And I think it is kind of odd it was released in January, because this is totally a spring album right here. The track Swift Breeze, I think, is one of the moments on the record where I think more of the hard rock and heavy metal inspiration kicks in. Not because there's, you know, heavy, crunchy guitars like you would expect in that kind of sound, but more in that, you know, the melodies have this very symphonic feel to them. And also the way she layers the guitars, and the fact that it is actually, you know, for an acoustic folk instrumental, you know, actually kind of one of the louder moments on the record. And, like, to the point of it not really being one of my favorite tracks on here, I do think if the track had a lot more dynamic contrast and felt a little less, you know, in your face, the track, I think, would have been more of a standout for me. Even though I do really like the urgency of the track quite a bit. Even though this album is composed mostly out of Yasmin's guitar, on the second half of the album, we actually do get a little more range, like we get a few more instruments to add to it, but they don't, overpower the songs. They actually sound complementary. One example is the track Adrift, which pairs Yasmin's guitar playing so painfully, gorgeously with some cello playing from Taryn Wood. I think the guitar and the cello, like, really complement each other. You know, they go together in such a way that I really can't really explain. And they compose these, like, very killer, fantastic melodies, like that part in the middle of the song, the dun 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 dun. Like, I think just the urgency of this track is definitely pretty spot on, and also because the album is so beautifully recorded, I think, you know, think it's very easy, you know, to hear all the little intricacies in the production of this album. So I like how spare it is. Like, you know, it definitely, you know, there's intricacies in the production, even when Yasmin is stacking her guitars, so there will be like 10 guitars in the mix. The song Through the Woods, I definitely think, is one of the big statement tracks of the record. I mean, just the melodies on this track are so incredibly catchy, and also definitely take me to this place that could be, you know, in a woods kind of environment. Like, this is one of those albums where I just picture her playing tracks like this kind of in the middle of nowhere, and like, it's a beautiful, very serene, kind of sunny spring day, and like, she's just kind of, you know, somewhere in the woods, you know, playing this guitar and composing these very transcendental kind of pieces of music. I think this song gives off that vibe in such an effective way, hence the name Through the Woods. So Through the Woods, and then about like 3 minutes into the song, she brings in a little more range by adding some kalimba in there that, again, I feel like really adds yet another dimension to the song. So the track Jarabi, I think, is fine. It definitely is a listenable enough track. However, I will say it is maybe the most underwhelming track on here. To me, it just kind of feels like ideas that have been that were iterated so well on previous tracks and just kind of repeated here and maybe done in a more kind of straightforward, kind of lesser way. I guess this more low-key track is kind of important after a track like Through the Woods, which definitely kind of, you know, gets the energy flowing while still not really making you want to rock out or anything. However, I will say the album ends on a pretty strong note. With the title track, Urban Driftwood, we actually have, surprisingly, one of the darker moments on the record. Like, I just love how hypnotic the song is, and the way she layers her guitars is pretty impeccable. Definitely similar in some ways to Swift Breeze in that it definitely sounds a little heavy metal inspired, only this track, I think, is better at doing this because it actually is more effective and has a more interesting kind of dynamic contrast. And even though it does have this rather repetitious melody throughout, it actually it's like in this very effective, kind of chilling, almost Swans to Be Kind of way. And I think the addition of kalimba on the track is really nice. And then we also have more intricate rhythms to the track, since we have some African percussion actually brought into the mix as well. And I think, you know, the usage of the djembe, I think, you know, and the kind of dook do 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 like rhythms that come in 3 minutes into the track, I mean, give the song a whole new flavor and dimension that I think just the way the song, you know, has that little quieter part and then the percussion comes in. It's a very seamless kind of transition into, you know, an even more intricate sound. Then we close things off with After the Storm, which couldn't have been a better way to end the record. And I think it is cool the way that the title track and this song are right next to each other, like right after arguably one of the more kind of, you know, furious sounding moments on the record. We have this very calm, very beautiful, I mean, it is definitely the calm after the storm, essentially. And the song has these very lovely, like, you know, melodies, which I think are actually coming out of this harp instrument called the, I think it's called a kora, and I think the guitar playing along with those kora notes are like just so beautiful. I mean, this is the one moment where I'm almost moved to tears, like tears of joy, that is, because like you know, the way she just layers everything and creates these very spellbinding melodies are just it's so good. And like, I definitely feel this emotional resonance that I just really can't explain. It's just like, mwah, chef's kiss, literally, and it's definitely, I think, the most fitting way to end this rather awe-inspiring and beautiful, progressive instrumental folk record. So yeah, I loved this record. I definitely knew it was probably going to be pretty cool from the way it sounded, but you know, I didn't know that I'd be this moved by it. I mean, this album definitely came out at a time when I kind of needed it most, and I'd say over time, you know, it's now May of 2021, it still continues to be one of the most inspiring kind of unsung gems of the year. But luckily, it actually seems to be getting acclaim, even in places where this kind of music isn't usually talked about. I mean, it's got a pretty good review on Pitchfork, and, you know, I mentioned, yeah, Uproxx's IndieCast. I know Uproxx's Stephen Hayden is a fan of this project, and, you know, I just hope that this album ends up being Yasmin's breakthrough, and I think this is only the beginning. Like, I'd love to see where she, you know, it'd be interesting to see how she progresses from this album. I definitely hope that, you know, we get a record that is somehow even better than this, because I think she's showing massive potential, and she's got one of the best albums of the year. So this is a strong 8 out of 10 for me. That is my review of Urban Driftwood, the new record from Yasmin Williams. And I'll see you for episode 287.